in valet form, and I very explicitly said, please always...
Fuel line from a weed whacker.
We go to go to our first night's driver's meeting, and there's a glorious Honda waiting for us, overheating. No fan switch turned on. So we jump in, drive to our driver's meeting, car's running a little hot. We park the coolant, work a little bit through it, seems pretty happy. Next day starts, leg one of the route. One unique thing about our daredevils is we were not allowed to have our cell phones, no GPS, it was paper maps only to find each turn. No direct communication with any of the other teams. We did have one other daredevil team that stuck with us, another Honda Accord. No, all three were Honda Accords. They had a 66% finish rate. A little foreshadowing. Some of them maybe didn't make it. We start off on our route, and it's a hot day in Texas. We're heading west. And it just is overheating. Henry was our first driver, and he had the attitude of, I'm just going for a problem. And it breaks, it breaks. And I'm like, oh, back just a little bit, pull it back. And Henry is worse than me with one speed, full throttle. So we start overheating. We pull over, we start looking over what's going on. We're just pushing coolant into the radiator overflow, and it overheats. So step one, we are overheating. Let's try and increase airflow to the front of the car. The grill lock. We didn't have working AC, so we pulled the AC condenser. We're on the side of the road, border patrol's driving past, and we're just ripping parts of the car. Load them up the trunk of the car and set off again. We get moving pretty well. Then she overheats again. We find a town near us on the map. We go to the town, we go into the parts store, we buy a different radiator cap, we buy some more coolant, and ratchet straps. The ratchet straps are for the hood. We decided to shed the hood, unbolt it to maximize all the airflow of the radiator that we could, strap it down to the roof, and set off again. And unfortunately, about 30 minutes later, we're back on the side of the road, overheating. And at that point, we kind of determined we've cracked the cylinder head, most likely from overheating, but it's just a small crack. It creates too much coolant pressure, pushes the coolant into the overflow, gotta stop, pour it back in the radiator. So every 30 minutes, we're pulling over, stopping, refilling it, just doing our best. As the day progresses, we're stopping a little bit quicker. We're doing everything we can to make this car happy. We take the ignition timing on the distributor, rotate
everything to make this car happy.
Reduce power.
That's the story of the Corrado.
It's not working. We're just barely limping along.
Keep the Corrado so happy.
It's running a little cool. So we're now pushing about 40 minutes, getting a little bit further, but obviously this car's there. Then it gets really, really, really late. And it turns out we're in Monument Valley, a very beautiful part of the country. We can't see anything, but we're soldiering on. The limo's constantly overheating. We're going through a copper line, which has stopping every 5 minutes to re-pour the coolant back into the radiators. It just keeps on shoving it out. But thankfully, we're recycling. We weren't leaking it out. We were contained. It's nearing midnight. We set out about 7:30 in the morning. We're a little bit exhausted, but we're just still trekking on. Finally, we arrive at the Red Hat Inn, 11:59 p.m. Our goal was to just get there right before the end of the day one. Turns out the overnight was just a little bit worried about our well-being because this is the first time they've done this. There you have two teams that haven't showed up when everyone else was there at 4 o'clock in the afternoon. They have no way of reaching out to us because our cell phones are locked away. We are disqualified if we take cell phones out, and our radio systems don't quite reach that far. So, I'm pretty sure we took about a year off Andy's life. Andy Medley, the organizer, just completely stressed about us, but we pull in. Henry was dressed in his suit as the driver. We were dressed as some just random celebrities in the back, and we come out, and everyone is like, oh my gosh, we made it. So, we ended day one hurt, and we tried couple fixes. I tried tightening up the cylinder head in the morning. Actually, someone had a torque wrench. We just took the engine partway apart. I retorqued the cylinder head just as a last-ditch effort. The day starts. New rules. The daredevils are to stay together, and the organizers were going to be right there with us. No more leaving the limo out in the desert alone. And we set out. And we get 3 miles in, and she cuts off. I'm running hot. Do a couple more things to try to limp it along. We get 4 miles out, and it cuts off again, and the organizers kind of warned us that we were about to hit some very dangerous territory, that if the limo died on the hill, conditions to break down beyond the side of the road. So we
voila.
Just enough to get back to the hotel. Ask the hotel.
One last thing.
To ship it back to us. We were going to hire a shipper. Bring it back out to Georgia because through all the
and we're installed. That fuel line makes it so easy to install the door card.
We named her Honda Rousey. Kept on taking a beating and moving on.